Did he just move?
Kenny called. He's in jail. He didn't leave a number. Sincerely, the guy on the couch.
Oh, hold on. I gotta get the guy some of this. The guy gotta taste this.
Yeah. Hey, guy. Hey, man. Sorry to wake you, but you gotta try this.
I don't need to tell you this, but this weed was the shit's little bam, snip, snap, snap.
So create dance. I am a can of whoop ass ready to open.
I really wish these niggas would stop fronting on me.
Niggas try to front, we move on them. Niggas think something sweet till we move on them. Yeah.
No real names are used to protect the innocent and the guilty. Now, you all know me and Black Slap Attack have known each other since 1993. At one point, we lived together as roommates along with our homeboy, the one and only Loke Dawg. As you seen in the beginning of the video, you see I had some half-baked references to a guy in a movie that was called Guy on the Couch. Well, we actually had a guy on the couch. His name was Little Mac. Little Mac had moved back to Greenville and he needed a place to stay. So he was like, yo man, let me crash with y'all. You know, I help pay a full for the bills or whatever. I'll just sleep on the couch. Cool. Now, my man kind of took over things when they moved in. The way the house was set up, we had three levels. Upstairs were the two bedrooms that me and Loke Dawg had, living room, and then downstairs in the basement, part of the basement was the studio. The other half of the basement was Black's half. And he had a bed and a sofa and TV and all that stuff set up down there. Now sometimes we would come home from work, and you know, us fellas, you know, we all singles. Brothers had to smash something, you know, they had to get busy, you know, hormones kick in. Well, since Lil Mac ain't had no bedroom, he had a cover down on the couch and used that or the floor to let us know that he had, you know, something going on downstairs. He always had some music up real loud. And it was crazy because it wouldn't be like no Jodeci or no Boyz II Men or nothing like that. No, one time me and the Loke Dawg came home from work and we got the car, we walking up to the door and we hear the Blade soundtrack. Now, he also smoked weed, lots of weed. Now, he will work an overnight shift from 11 p.m. to 7 in the morning. He will smoke up before he leave to work. He will come home in like an hour or two after he got to work on a quote-unquote lunch break, smoke some more. One time, a boy came home from work. I said, what you doing here? He said, boss man, I'm trying to go tap something on the side so he couldn't have his car gone from the plant. So he told me to drop him off. He gonna page me when he through. What? What type of job is this? And where can I apply it? When he came home in the morning, sit in the room and light a blunt up. I mean, the weed was so strong, it smelled like he was sitting at the head of my bed about to have a conversation with me. Like, I would smell it, and then I had to crack my eye open to see he won't sit in the room with me. Craziest thing is, he would light a blunt, smoke it, start watching a porno, pass out. So every time I woke up in the middle of the afternoon, come downstairs, he's sitting in the living room, still in his uniform. The blunt is burnt to his fingers, halfway smoked, and then sometimes you smell something burning, you go in the kitchen, this man done burnt some oodles and noodles in the pot. Really, homie? You trying to kill us? Well, one time we at the house, me and Loke Dawg, my homeboy Son of Jarrell 1 comes over with his roommate. We're gonna play a little bit of Need for Speed. At this time, it was a Need for Speed out where you had your custom cars all saved on your memory card on your PlayStation, and you would race for cars. Like, you lost, your car was transferred to the winner's memory card. So we at the house, we playing Need for Speed. We probably been there for like hour or so, and then you start to hear something coming from the basement. Hear somebody walking up the steps, because the steps are wooden, so they, of course, they'll creak every time you take a step. So soon I heard a footstep. I said, oh lord, that's Mac coming up the step. And they were like, Mac? Like, yeah, my homeboy, Lil Mac. And so the door opens up. I swear to God, this could have been like a slow motion Spike Lee movie scene. The basement door opens. All you see is a cloud of smoke, like a thick cloud of smoke. Like, if anybody didn't know any better, you'll think the basement was on fire. So of course at this time, Son of Jarrell 1 and his roommate, they used to smoke weed too. So soon they see the smoke, I don't know if they could smell it first or could tell by the color of the smoke, they already knew what time it was. Then through the smoke, come this little 5'1 dude with a blunt in his hand. They looking at him with a glazed look. He gives a head nod, they get a head nod back, and they need no words exchanged. Son of Jarrell 1 and his roommate gets up, they go down in the basement with him. My company done left me and abandoned me for a guy on the couch. And they smoke up for an hour. Now these dudes ain't never met each other before in their life. but I guess we will bring people together. True story. All right, y'all. Hope y'all found that funny. SlickJC, your notorious B.I.G., brother in gaming, and I'm up out of here. Peace.
Thurgood, why don't you get your boy the guy to lend you some money, yo? You certainly let him stay here long enough.
Man, that's Brian's boy. I let him stay here.
I don't know, man.
Hey, what day is it?
Saturday.
Is it January?
No, man, it's August. Hey, seeing as how we don't know who you are and all, are you planning on moving out anytime soon?
Thurgood, why don't you just focus on one thing at a time?
I'll be fine.
Right here, y'all need to watch some videos. That little plus button that's beside that subscribe word, you need to click on that. I got more vlogs to do. I got more videos to do. I got more games to play. I got some more people to cuss out. I'm gone. Peace.